Identical twins are identical. Go figure. But we often assume they are identical in every way possible. Their DNA is supposedly the same. They often sound the same. They sure look similar to the point where sometimes even they can't tell each other apart in photos. I'm speaking from experience. Watching my identical twin brothers try to identify themselves in baby pictures is honestly painful. One of them even spoke to a mirror for a brief moment, fully believing it was his brother. But just because we see a lot of similarities in identical twins doesn't mean they're exactly the same. So let's take a look into five ways identical twins aren't all that identical, including their DNA. You've probably heard that no human's fingerprints are the same as anyone else's. They're like snowflakes, all completely unique and beautiful in their own way. Now, of course, this would be true for strangers, but surely it can't be true for identical twins, right?
Wrong!
Yes, identical twins tend to have very similar fingerprints. And when you look at the different fingerprint pattern types, like whorls, arches, and loops, you are likely to find the same pattern types on identical twins. But again, these are similarities, not identicalities, if that's even a word. Their fingerprints still have differences, even if it takes a computer to see them. A 2012 study collected fingerprints from identical twins at a Beijing Twins Cultural Festival. Sounds like a hoot and a half to me. They ran these fingerprints through fingerprint identification software to better understand the differences between the prints of twins. And they found that while more similar than non-twins, identical twin fingerprints are indeed different. The software was able to distinguish between them most of the time. So don't go committing crimes in hopes of incriminating your twin. Your fingerprints are different enough that that probably won't work. Also, that would just be mean. A fetus's fingerprints form in the womb between weeks 13 and 19 of pregnancy, and a number of factors go into determining what they'll look like. Umbilical cord length, position in the womb, blood pressure, nutrition, the rate of finger growth. You'd think living in the same womb for 9 months would mean these factors would be pretty similar for twins, but differences in some of them are enough to create all kinds of variation. And those variations can be a lot more noticeable than fingerprints, like height and weight. Not all twins are exactly the same size, even as babies. A 2016 study found that firstborn twins were typically larger in weight and height than their younger twin, even when they were born minutes apart. The differences weren't always huge, but they were there. While researchers in this study weren't exactly sure what was driving that difference in size, the placenta may have something to do with it. Previous studies have suggested that the weight of the placenta is positively correlated with the birth weights of babies. Basically, bigger placenta, easier nutrient transfer from mom, bigger baby. So if the twins do not share a placenta, the weight of their respective placentas would likely factor into how much each twin weighs. But even if they do share a placenta, you need to consider if they grow in the same amniotic sac. Growing within the same sacs could affect how the umbilical cord reaches the babies, impacting their nutrient transfer and blood flow, and therefore their size. These differences in sizes often persist into childhood. It can even persist into adulthood. One of my brothers was born just a tad smaller, and now they're full-grown adults, and that same brother is still a tad smaller than his twin. Sometimes those size differences arise after they've left the womb, though. Illness can play a role in growth when you're young, and just because two people are twins doesn't mean they'll get sick at the same time. In identical twins with a height difference of an inch or more, a study shows that the one that got sick more as a child is the one that typically ends up being shorter as an adult. So not only did they get teased by their twin for always being sick, now they gotta put up with being teased for being shorter. The jokes never stop when you're a twin.
This SciShow video is supported by Jump, a statistical analysis software that makes powerful analytics quick and accessible. We might all wish we had a crystal ball, but you don't need one when you can take your future into your own hands with Jump's data-based predictions. Jump offers point-and-click modeling procedures for the best possible prediction. With Jump, you can take advantage of techniques like regression, neural networks, decision trees, and more. But a good prediction isn't just about using the right model. It's also about validating how accurate that model's predictions are. So they also offer validation procedures that prevent overfitting. That way, your models and predictions can be the best that they can be. And the best part is that you don't need to write out any of these scripts. You can just compare which model makes the most sense for your data and get going. So if you want to get going today, head to jump.com/scishow and you'll even get a 30-day free trial.
Since nutrition affects growth as well, let's talk about the differences in food preferences and gut microbiomes among twins. Everyone has trillions of microbes living in their guts. Sounds gross, but really, we would have a pretty tough time without them. They help us break down nutrients from all the wonderful and not so wonderful foods that we eat every day. Some of them grow best in our bodies when we eat certain foods, like carbs, proteins, and fiber. There's even evidence that they can influence our diet and cravings by a few different mechanisms, including communicating with our brains. They like what they like, and they aren't afraid to let it be known. All of this is to say that when we crave a certain food, that's often our symbiotic gut buddies telling us what they want to eat. But what determines the makeup of our gut microbiome? Well, it's determined partially by our genetics. So you'd imagine identical twins have similar gut microbiomes. And that's true. In fact, identical twins have gut microbiomes more similar than even fraternal twins do, suggesting that DNA is playing a part here. But they're also determined by our environment. And growing up in the same house doesn't mean environmental factors don't create differences between you and your twin. So, slightly different gut microbuddies equals differences in food preferences. For example, one of my brothers loves cornbread and the other can't stand it. One likes chocolate, the other isn't a fan. Needless to say, putting the right plate with the right food in front of the right twin can be a challenge. And even if you manage to give the right twin the right plate, which side of the plate do you need to put their utensils on? And no, the answer doesn't depend on if they're eating salad or dessert. I mean, which hand do they use to eat? That's right, twins don't always have the same dominant hand. One of my brothers is right-handed, the other is left-handed. I always thought that would make it easier for them to share one of those goofy two-headed holiday sweaters. Now, identical twins do have the same dominant hand slightly more often than fraternal twins do. This would suggest that genetics probably influences handedness. But there are still plenty of differently handed sets of identical twins out there. In fact, they could make up as much as 20% of identical twin pairs. So surely environment factors into this equation too, right? Well, one study tested this by looking at twins that were raised in different households. Those are called reared apart twins. The reared apart twins had a higher rate of different handedness than twins raised together, suggesting there is an environmental aspect to this. What determines handedness is still pretty up in the air. But it seems both environmental and genetic factors are at play. And identical twins are often the subjects of genetic studies like this because they have the exact same DNA, right? Turns out, no, they don't. But it is pretty dang similar. Identical twins arise when one sperm cell fertilizes one egg cell, creating a single zygote. That is why the medical term for identical twins is monozygotic twins. One zygote. That zygote then splits into two, creating two different cell clusters that will grow into two different human beings. But if they started from the exact same egg and sperm cells, how could their DNA possibly differ? Maybe you've already guessed. Mutations! Mutations occur in our DNA constantly. When the zygote splits, each twin has the same genome. But then the cells start dividing and developing totally independently. When replicating as much genetic material as we have, there are bound to be mistakes. And those mistakes aren't made in the same places in the DNA just because two people happen to be twins. But unfortunately, it doesn't stop there. Those differences in DNA caused by mutations can even produce identical twins with different birth anomalies. While it isn't common, one identical twin can be born with a clubfoot or spina bifida, and the other is completely unaffected. Which means, in some identical twin pairs, there are profound differences. Of course, identical twins are similar in a lot of ways. I mean, starting out from the same zygote is gonna produce two individuals who look a lot alike. But just because two people are identical twins does not mean they are the same person. And science supports that. For all you identical twins out there who keep getting lumped together, now you can tell everyone a few ways in which you and your twin are not so identical. I'm still probably gonna make fun of my brothers for failing to identify themselves in photos, though. Sorry.